Houston, the Power 11, we're moving at the proper rate.
Hallelujah. Houston, it looks great to us now, over.
Yeah, it looks fine here, Charlie. The 7/10 part's the only part I don't find explained yet.
Roger, Mike. We're working on that one right now. We're coming up with a story soon, over.
Thank you.
Houston, we're handing over Tom to correction from Goldstone to Honeysuckle, over.
Okay.
Houston, go ahead, over.
You sound good to us, Honeysuckle. How are we sound?
Roger, flyby, Mike. We'd like the Omni configuration as follows. Omni Alpha placed in Bravo. Omni to Omni. High gain track to manual. High gain yaw to 70 pitch.
This is Apollo Control. At the present time, we are handing over from the tracking site at Goldstone, California, to the site at Honeysuckle, which accounts for the noise in the transmission.
I've got S-band Omni B, Omni, track to manual, and beam Y. Pitch, you better say that again, yaw 270, over.
Roger, Buzz. I broke up at pitch minus 50 and beam wide, over.
Roger, copy.
Again, over.
Roger, are you ready to copy some numbers on cruise status report,
etc.? Roger, go ahead, over.
Okay, radiation CDR 11005, NMC 10006, LMC 09007. Medication negative. And I got some battery and RCS numbers over here.
Go ahead, over.
Battery C, 37.1. Pyro battery A and B, both 37.1. RCS Alpha, 82. Bravo, 84. Coca, 85. Delta, 87. Over.
Roger, we copy radiation 11005, 10006, 09er 007, no medication, 37.1, 37.1, 37.1, 82, 84, 85, 87, over.
That's permanent. Anyway, 11 GM Delta P is 1.1.
Roger, copy, 1.1. Apollo 11, Houston, please verify the four cryo heaters auto, the four fans off. Over.
Okay, we've been holding O2 heater number one in the off position. I believe that was your last instruction. All the other heaters are auto and all fans are off. Over.
Roger, stand by. 11 Houston, we'd like all heaters auto, over.
Roger, all four auto, all four fans off.
Apollo 11 Houston, as the sun sinks slowly in the west, the white team bids you good night. If we get a story on the 7/10, we can give it to you in about 15 minutes or so. If not, we'll give it to you in the morning. Over.
Okay, that sounds fine, Charlie. Thanks very much. Today, Charlie.
All right, good night, all.
This is Apollo Control at 36 hours, 11 minutes. At the present time, Apollo 11 is about 134,000 nautical miles from Earth. The velocity is 4,216 feet per second. During that last series of transmissions from the crew, we received a status report from Buzz Aldrin. He reported that the crew has, in the past 24 hours, taken no medication. This is similar to the crew status report that we received from them last night. We bid them good night at 36 hours, 9 minutes, or about 2 minutes ago. We anticipate that the crew will probably have a few more housekeeping type chores aboard the spacecraft before they actually turn in, and also will probably be combining their eat period with the first part of that sleep period. At 36 hours, 12 minutes into the flight of Apollo 11, this is Mission Control, Houston. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
This is Apollo Control at 36 hours, 27 minutes. We have completed the processing of the unscheduled television transmission, which the crew sent down from the spacecraft at about 30 hours, 24 minutes ground elapsed time this evening. I would like to repeat that this was an apparent test of the onboard system. The crew turned the television equipment on, left it on for about 52 minutes. Some of the time we will have a picture, other parts of it we don't have good lock on, and will not have a good solid picture. We should also point out that this transmission was made with the omnidirectional antennas, which of course don't provide nearly the signal strength that we would get from the high gain antenna, which would be used. And we'll play back the tape of that transmission for you at this time. This is Apollo Control. The view that we have at the present time appears to be out the window of the command module, looking at the lunar module docking target. And we seem to have a fairly good view here of the interior of the command module. This would look to be the panel, the display panel with some of the fuel quantity dials on the right side of the cockpit. At the time these television pictures were transmitted from the spacecraft, Apollo 11 was about 121,000 nautical miles from Earth. Where we do have good signal lock-on, we got amazingly good quality from those little Omni antennas. As we've mentioned before, normally the high-gain antenna would be used for a television transmission of this sort. could almost make out a face in that one. And somebody's hand down at the instrument panel. That last view just before we lost picture lockup appeared to be the right center portion of the main display console, main display panel in the command module. For a brief moment there, we had a picture of a somewhat placid Neil Armstrong closing his eyes momentarily. Another crewman to his left. I'm not sure at this point that I can make out who it was. It did appear it might have been Mike Collins.
called up. Go ahead, 11.
Oh, Charlie, is that you?
That's me. How are you there?
Oh, just fine. How's the all-white team today?
The all-white team's bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. We're ever alert down here.
Ever alert, vigilant. Hey, you got any medics down there watching heart rate? I'm trying to do some running in place down here, and I'm wondering just out of curiosity whether it brings my heart rate up.
Well, they will spring into action here momentarily. Stand by.
Well, that was Mike Collins commenting that he was doing some running in place exercises. We may get a brief view of that a little later on in this transmission if the picture stabilizes and holds still for us.
Hello, 11. We see your heart beating.
Okay, well, there's the CDR, and the CMB didn't go up any. We're all running in place.
I'd like to see that site. Why don't you give us a TV picture of that one?
I think
that's great.
You got it.
Okay, it's coming in a go, though, Buzz. I guess Bruce said we don't have it here in this center.
Goldstone should be getting about the best picture of the Earth we can get right now.
Roger, Mike. Thank you much.
We got a little distortion horizontal direction standing on our monitor. I wonder if they're getting the same thing.
Stand by, Buzz. I'll let you know.
I guess it would be more described as a waviness.
Goldstone MNO, Houston Capcom.
Goldstone MNO.
Okay, the crew is complaining of some horizontal banding on their monitor. Do y'all see that on the picture?
Stand by.
They wouldn't see it right now. We don't have anything in focus, Charlie.
Roger, he's checking on it. I'll see if they had it earlier. Stand by.
I guess when we're showing the disky or when we're showing the Earth might be the better time.
Okay.
Houston Capcom Goldstone.
Go ahead.
Okay, our TV people confirm they see this horizontal bend.
Okay. 11 Houston, the Goldstone TV people also see the banding when same time y'all do, over.
Okay, would they call it a horizontal waviness instead of banding, maybe?
No, I'm not talking to them directly. Stand by, Buzz. Let me see how they describe it. Goldstone MNO, Houston Capcom, could you put the TV gal on the loop, please?
Capcom Goldstone, roger. Goldstone MNO, Net 1.
Go.
The TV people do not have access to Net 1 in that area. I suggest we use Net 2 for that purpose.
Okay, going to Net 2. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. The Goldstone TV guys say that they have some horizontal banding across the upper part of the picture and across the lower part. They would consider the lines just straight, no waviness to them at all, over.
Roger, I understand. They do seem to distort vertical lines, though.
Say again about the vertical lines, Buzz.
When there's a vertical line, these horizontal bands tend to form waves in it.
Roger, I copy. He didn't mention that. Stand by, I'll check again. Ghost Zone TV said that when you get a sharp vertical line on a picture where the horizontal banding goes across, it does appear to bend it slightly. The same as Apollo 10, they said. Looks okay to them, over.
Okay, I understand. It's not a
monitor, but
maybe there's
a transmitter. All right, yeah, I guess so. But we'll have to look into it and see if they can suggest anything.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, we've lost our command interface with Ghost Zone. We'd like you to switch to Omni Delta, over.
Roger, Link, Delta.
Roger.
Apollo 11 Houston, we'd like you to terminate the O2 purge if you have not done so already. And the TV camera people say that the lines are inherent in a camera buzz and it's something that we expected. Over.
Roger, understand about the camera. Say again about the O2 purge.
Roger, we can terminate the O2 purge at this time. Over.
Oh, okay. Fine, we'll do.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. Please select Omni Bravo on board, over.
Take on the Bravo, Jimmy.
Roger.
How's everything going down there? You guys happy with spacecraft systems?
Roger, affirmative. Everything's looking really good to us, over.
Okay, same here. How far out can you pick up TV off the Omni?
Stand by. Apollo 11 Houston, we're just about at the limits where we can get any kind of picture at all on the Omnis on the TV. The picture, I guess, would be just almost zero at this point.
Okay, well, for this TV program coming up in a couple of hours, you might give some thought to how you want us to stop PTC, if you do, for the best high gain angle, and also it'd be nice if you could stop us at such an attitude that we'd have the Earth out of one of our windows.
Roger, 11, we're thinking about that.
Okay.
This is Apollo Control. That concludes the replay of the test transmission from Apollo 11. That transmission occurred about 2 hours prior to the regularly scheduled TV transmission this evening. The crew apparently testing out the onboard system. We received about 52 minutes of intermittent television using the spacecraft omnidirectional antennas. And as you can see, it's particularly near the end. This is appears to be just about the limit of television reception from the Omni antennas. At the time of the transmission, Apollo 11 was about 121,000 nautical miles from Earth. During the replay of that television transmission, we accumulated a very short amount of tape, one or two brief comments from the crew, who are in their sleep period at this time. We'll play back that tape conversation for you now.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. One request. The optics switched to zero, and we've got a lot of theories on why it maneuvered at 7/10 a moment ago, Mike, but no real definite answer. We'll be back with you later. Over.
Okay, no rush, Charlie. Thank you.
I think we can explain that 7/10 rate. When the first time through, you know, we failed to go through the VIR 49, so we had a large error between our actual CDU and desired CDU and roll. And with that situation, the DAP, or the vehicle will roll, or will maneuver, rather, at a rate as that is loaded in, which was 3/10, plus 4/10 rate, and it will limit at 4/10 above the desired rate. So that is, if we have a large enough angle between the desired and the actual, which we did. So therefore, the rate was 4/10 plus 3/10, give you the 7/10. Over.
Okay. Thank you.
Roger. Thank you.
This time, Apollo 11 is 137,219 nautical miles from Earth. The spacecraft is traveling at a speed of 4,132 feet per second. Here in Mission Control, things have settled down into a rather quiet nighttime routine. We said goodnight to the crew at about 36 hours, 9 minutes to be exact, a little over an hour ago. We did hear from them once or twice since then, and we anticipate that at this time they are probably getting settled down to begin their 10-hour sleep period. At 37 hours, 21 minutes, this is Apollo Control.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 38 hours, 26 minutes. Here in Mission Control, we are presently going through the shift change. Flight Director Glenn Lunny and his team of flight controllers are coming on to replace Gene Kranz. The capsule communicator on the upcoming shift will be astronaut Ron Evans. Flight Surgeon John Ziegelschmidt reported that two of the three crewmen apparently began sleeping at about 38 hours ground elapsed time, or about 26 minutes ago. The two that are asleep are Command Module Pilot Mike Collins and Commander Neil Armstrong. Lunar Module Pilot Buzz Aldrin at last report was still awake. We expect the change of shift press briefing will occur at about 11:15 Central Daylight Time. At 38 hours, 27 minutes, this is Apollo Control, Houston.
focus.
Thank you.
Thank you.